In our modern world, the easiest and most efficient way of distributing large amounts of energy is through electricity. Electricity is made up of positive and negative static and moving charges, like protons and electrons. These repel similar charges and attract their opposites. Pushing like charges together or pulling opposite charges apart takes work, which stores electrical potential energy in the form of a field between them. This potential energy is released when we allow the charges to move together or to push apart. The amount of field energy acting on individual charges in an area is called the electric potential. The difference in electric potential between two isolated areas is called the potential difference and is measured in volts. If we connect the two areas with a material that allows charges to flow, we make a circuit. Charges will be pushed and pulled through the circuit in an attempt to balance the fields. We call this movement an electrical current and measure it in amperes. The amount of current flow multiplied by the potential difference between the two points is equal to the amount of power being moved or used and is measured in watts. 1 amp flowing through a potential difference of 1 volt delivers 1 watt of power. Current can flow through a circuit in only one direction at a time. If that current always flows in the same direction, it's called direct current, or DC. But if it regularly changes directions, it's called an alternating current, or AC. The voltage of an alternating current looks like a wave, and has a frequency, an amplitude, and a phase when compared to other AC flows of the same frequency. All materials oppose the flow of charges, at least a little bit. This opposition, called resistance, is measured in ohms. Special items, called loads, resist the current's flow in a way that extracts the current's power. Resistors, inductors, and capacitors are three types of loads that form the basic building blocks of most circuits. Resistors convert electric power into heat or light, inductors store power as a magnetic field, and capacitors store power as an electrostatic field. Since the current flowing into and out of the circuit must be the same, the energy removed reduces the voltage across the load. This is a loss of 1 volt for every 1 amp crossing a 1 ohm resistor. Power loss through capacitors and inductors is more complicated because their behavior depends more on how the circuit is set up. Resistors usually act the same way for both AC and DC power, while capacitors and inductors don't. Capacitors briefly allow direct current to pass through them as they build their electrostatic field before building a high resistance to the flow. Inductors are the opposite, temporarily stopping the flow of direct currents as it builds its magnetic field before letting it pass at low resistance. Alternating current is constantly changing flow directions, and if its frequency is high enough, it passes through a capacitor without distortion. On the other hand, higher frequencies make it harder for AC to flow through inductors, as the inductor's magnetic field has to continually change directions with the current. Fortunately, a changing magnetic field also induces a current in nearby wires, allowing inductors to transfer power through magnetism, and making things like transformers, motors, and radio possible. While there are a lot of other parts that can make up electric circuits and important fancy equations that describe what's going on in better detail, these fundamental pieces form the bulk of how we interact with electricity on a daily basis, making them the basic facts about electricity that everyone should know. For Tech Laboratories, I'm Tech Adams, saying keep thinking, and thanks for watching. Wow, that was fast, but that's okay because I've turned the entire thing into an infographic that you can download, links in the description below. If you feel so inclined, maybe check out some of my other videos, or share this video with a friend, and subscribe to Tech Laboratories for more videos on science and technology. See you next time! Either 365 on a normal year or 366 on a leap year. But a full solar year, which is the average time between two identical successive equinoxes, that's a refresh rate equivalent of 500 hertz. But on the other hand, when we blink, we black out our field of view for a third of a second, between 300 and 400 milliseconds, and our brain just filters it out.